Alright, welcome back. We find ourselves in Sector 3. This is where hard mode runs are usually you make them or you break them. As far as really getting through the hump of transitioning from one shielded enemies to two shielded enemies, which is a huge difference. I think we're in pretty good shape because we managed to get that extra weapon, but we'll see where it goes from here. So let's see, we've got a distress. Those are especially good in NG sectors. This is a bit of an awkward shape. I'm glad I spotted this ahead of time. So we'll want to go down this way, and then wind up here with enough time. At least we've got plenty of extra beacons over here to properly calibrate ourselves to jump out at the right moment. So yeah, probably jump around down here, and I don't know if I'm going to go down here or up through here. Probably down here because of this extra beacon, but we'll see. This is a bit of an awkward bottleneck, but so's this, so kind of comes out in the wash. So, maybe down here. We'll see. We'll figure it out. I do want to spend money now. Kind of. We're in pretty good shape. I think we just need to upgrade our ship, so... Oh yeah, we have the artillery beam. I was worried about ships with defense drone too, but artillery beam will kill them eventually. Most NG ships usually don't have that nasty of weapons, although sometimes they do, but if they don't, then artillery beam will take care of them, so that I don't really have to worry about that. So I guess just engines, or maybe shields, I don't know. One of those, but probably engines. It'll be good for, again, we're still going to be seeing, even this late into the game, we're going to be seeing ships with one laser, or two lasers, and a missile. Not like this, though. Yeah, we got plenty of fuel. Yeah, take it all. Take it all. Alright. I'm not even angry. That's fine. That gives us plenty of scouting info. Lots of neutral events. Very few fights, but that's pretty standard op most of the time. We'll probably... It's a little bit interesting. So this might actually be a good place to dive, actually. Because we could get a bunch of scrap, go to the exit, get scrap, go to the store, and then back to the exit. So, we'll see. So, this might actually mean it might be a good idea to upgrade to sensors level 2, then. There's a lot of events in here where that helps. Like, neutral events. Ships with... stuff with no ship detected. So, I don't know. We'll see. Probably not gonna upgrade the medbay, though. We've got plenty of crew. Okay. That's fine. I can sell that at a store. It's... possible I might want to use that in a fight, although that's really iffy. The hull missiles are awful. They are not good weapons at all. At least for the most part, but they're stopgap at best. I'll put it that way. Yeah, I guess I'm gonna go down here because there's the fight, so I guess I'm gonna... How do I want to set this up? I want to visit most of these, probably. So, I guess I'm gonna go here and then directly to these fights and then see where we're at then. Although, you could make an argument for visiting some fights that might be non-combat and just give you free stuff, upgrade, and then go to the fights. That's another good school of thought. I have time to do either. Like, I can take some of these beacons and put them over here. So, I think there's enough of an argument to take both of these instead of just one. I think I can spare it. I've got time, I think. Alright, what have we got? A refueling platform. Let's see, so there's many ways this can go wrong. I don't have the upgraded doors. I would be fine with taking the hull damage if it meant a fight, I think. Yeah, so I'll try my luck. Ah, see. This is the bad result. This is the one where you take 3 damage and there's no fight. So, oh well. I think it was worth the gamble, though. Alright, crew. Beat up those, these fearsome borders. Tell you what. You go over here. You go over here. Is that gonna be good enough? Well, it's gonna be good enough for now. Alright, you provide reinforcements, I guess? I don't know. I mean, look at these guys. They're pathetic. But, so it goes. Get out of here. Yeah, you guys have to start repairing the engines, too. You know, good thing I'm not speedrunning the game, or this would have been a real problem. If I were speedrunning, I'd be doing a lot of things differently, I'll tell you that. That's not really something I do. That's, you know, it's exciting, it's fun to watch, but, it's just not really the way I like to play this game. So, that's, yeah, I might do that eventually, but probably not right now. Yeah, I just don't play this game that often anymore. It's time-consuming. It's, you know, it turns out crossing the entire galaxy, it kind of takes a little while. Yeah, now you gotta walk all the way up there. Probably a good idea to let you finish before you jump. Probably wise. There we go. And yeah, like I said, I've gotta jump here and then to one of these. So we're a little bit down on hull, but hopefully we'll get that fixed sooner or later. Alright, let's jump into a Sector 3 fight, see what we've got. Okay, two shields, like I thought. They have hacking. This could actually be really nasty, actually. We have the Leto, though, which... it should not be understated how useful this thing is. If, on the result of one evasion roll, we hit them in the weapons, we have a fairly good chance of rendering them harmless, because one damage to their weapons shuts off one of these and makes them a lot less scary. Most of the time, the hacking won't be an issue, so I think I will go ahead and risk this fight. We can usually do better than 14 scrap in Sector 3, I think. And yeah, see, they're only hacking our medbay. Now, that is a bit of a choke point. If they hit us in the shields, that could be a bit of an issue. But I gotta remember to fire this thing at the start of the fight. In fact, I can even get this off. Alright, now we're in good shape. And the Ion Blast 2 will make it fairly easy to get through the shields. Not super easy, but at least this early in the game, enemies won't have terribly good evasion. So the Ion Blast 2 alone will do the job. So yeah, let's just lock down their evasion and keep hitting them with the dual lasers and we should be fine. I'll go ahead and shoot another shot at the weapons though, just to make sure they don't do anything sneaky. I'm alright if they let this on, because at least we can get a little bit of dodge training against this. You know, if they ever fire it. Alright, so now we can try and dodge these. Yeah, so you gotta dodge. Excellent. That didn't waste too much time. And yeah, what do we want now? Probably just another power. Yeah, probably just another power. Keep the engines running a little bit smoother. Sure. Yeah, those are good rewards, usually. Oh man, Combat 2 and Sector 3. Wow. Alright, thankfully their main weapons are not that bad. But, it's probably worth shooting a Leto over here, just to make sure that, that thing goes down. That's clearly the most threatening thing here. We do not want them hitting us with that heavy laser. Getting any bright ideas. In fact, you need to be over in shields yesterday. Well, I guess that works. Alright, engines, I guess? Yeah. I'm gonna lock them down a bit more. So, yeah, I swear I did not do that on purpose. Okay, I did not really think about that. I thought it was just gonna be a small bomb. Thankfully it's just oxygen. It's only oxygen, an unimportant system. So, we should be fine from here. So, yeah, that shield recharge rate, we really need it. And as I suspected, they actually did have a buffer in here. They had 5 drone points. So, thankfully they only had the one combat 2 instead of like 2 combat 1s or a combat 1 and a beam 1 or something. That could have been really rough. But I believe we got them on lockdown now. Let me just make sure this ion bomb doesn't land anywhere important. Okay, they're gonna turn off these two things, but we've already got their shields down, so I don't really care. So that's fine. I could have rearranged the order of my weapons if I really needed to, before that went off, but thankfully I didn't need to this time. And I think I stacked enough ion damage on their shields, I should be able to sneak this extra set of dual lasers through, and not have to wait for all this to come back online. Yes, I can. Okay, good. Alright, that could have been dicey, but thankfully it wasn't. And fairly good rewards. Good. So now I guess the question is, do I want to buy another power and run two shields and four engines, or do I just want to go ahead and spend this 40 scrap immediately on shields 2.5? That is a fairly powerful upgrade in its own right. I'm going to go ahead and send you back to doors before I forget. And I think we're doing well enough, that's probably a good idea. That makes it easier to justify spending 60 on three shields later. So yeah, I'm going to go ahead and do it. That could certainly be handy in the meantime. Till we decide what else to do with our money. So I guess eventually we'll sell the defense drone one and the hull missile when we run into a store, but because it doesn't seem like they're really fitting into our loadout right now. They're just sitting around gathering dust. Alright, yeah, this is certainly worth spending another missile on. Yeah, just keep finding ships that are just a good idea to shoot a missile at. And we've got the missiles to do it, so we might as well do it. Oh, nice. I think that was our, no, it wasn't weapons training. Oh, it must have been an Artemis missile. Yeah, it must have been an Artemis missile, because it's already fired. So it just turned that off, so that's good. Alright, so this should be enough to keep the shields down. You're going to abandon that. Good. Looks like we've got it all handled then. Because I should be able to get that Artemis missile offline there. There we go. You're not going to be able to break anything yet. Artemis artillery beam. Still charging. Yeah, I think we've got this pretty much in hand. Alright, now they're not going to be able to dodge for anything, for beans. So, life is good. Alright, he's gonna come back. I'm gonna hit him with the dual lasers, because I timed that perfectly. Definitely not accidental at all. Definitely not. So, good. Good. So, eventually, we might upgrade the artillery beam, but there's no particular reason to right now. And no such luck. I was hoping they'd give us the free repair that I was talking about all last episode, but, not yet. We're still doing fine, though. I think I actually miscounted, though. Yeah, I did not actually have time to get that extra beacon there. Exit's gonna get overrun before I can get there. Alright, well, I wanted to make things exciting, so, guess that's the way we're gonna do it. Well, with that in mind, I kind of want to prioritize the level 5 engines then. Glad I got that level 2 piloting. So, yeah, probably want to... Well, I don't know. Yeah, do I want to buy the power now, or buy the engines first and then the power? Probably engines first and then power. That's usually a good way of, rule of thumb is, you know, whenever you want to upgrade something, buy the system bar first and then the power later. Yeah, we'll listen to your problem. Yeah, sure. We've got a human that, we can communicate with him with. Now, do we want a crew member, or do we just want 40 scrap? That's the question. Do we want to sell a Mantis for 40 scrap? The Mantis could help. He's very fast, repels borders. You don't always get opportunities of free crew, and just having extra crew on hand is helpful. But on the other hand, 40 scrap is 40 scrap. That's 40 scrap just put right into the engines. So, that's it. I think I'm gonna try and struggle along without the crew. I think engines are helpful. There's not a lot of substitute for good engines, whereas you can usually micromanage well enough to handle without the crew. Eventually, we'll probably get another chance at a crew anyway, but I don't know. This is, like, it's 40 scrap for, yeah. Like, we're eventually, especially we're like, we're paying 40 scrap for the Mantis. I think if we, like, run into a slaver next sector, it's gonna be, like, if we blow them up, that would be, like, paying, like, 30 scrap for a Mantis or something like that, so it might be a little bit better to get the free crew then. Yeah, so I think with that in mind, I think I just want the 40 scrap, so I will go ahead and take the engines. Especially because engines are useful for what we need up ahead, anyway. So, yeah, we're not going to... Are we going to go to that store? We still can. Like, that's not going to get taken over in time. We will get there, so... Probably we don't want to actually spend our money yet. I mean, I think at this rate we're just going to get there, because we're going to get here, the exit will be taken over, but the store won't, so we might as well go to the store. I think that's what I'm thinking. Alright. Well, that's that settled, then. Yeah, can we help? No? No? Okay. I wanted to help. How's this gonna work? Am I actually gonna get an extra jump before the store? I think I might. Well, we'll see. We'll be able to measure it when we get up here. But I'm gonna jump here, and then we'll see if I can jump here or not. Intruder on deck. Okay, here's another chance at a free crew. On the other hand, it is risking more hull damage, and we're already low on hull. So I think in this case, it's better to try and get less hull damage and try and get more scrap. Alright, good. I approve. So yeah, I think I've got just enough time to jump here and then the store and then go to the exit. Yeah, okay. So we ended up, like, diving the exit, but we got two extra beacons out of it, one of which was a store, so I think we're gonna get a pretty good benefit out of it. And we've got the hull missile to sell, so we might even be able to put our defense drone up. We'll see, though. In any case, we'll get the repairs, which will make the dive easier. We don't have to worry about them having, like, a Hermes missile or a breach missile or something. Free scrap, more stuff to sell at the store. We're doing great. Okay, we're in good shape. Even though the rebels took over the exit, we're in good shape. Alright, not what I want to see at a store, but at the very least, we can at least get rid of some of our garbage. So, hull missile is out. I think I can safely get rid of the beam drone. Let's just see where we stand now. We still don't necessarily want to get rid of the defense drone, but let's just see what we can buy with this money. Got 129. We, honestly, I think it's a good idea to spend it on this, and then two of these. That's gonna make us a lot safer from nasty laser and flak barrages. We can redirect more power into engines as necessary. We could even turn off our weapons to get more into engines. We'll see. So how much would we get from this? 25. So that would put us up to 44. Which would give us enough to still only buy one power. So really the question is how much do we want one power right now? That would let us comfortably keep all our weapons online and go from 3 shields, 3 engines to 3 shields, 4 engines, which I think helps. I think that does help. So, like, even though this increases my flexibility, I do have plenty of drones now. Yeah, it's iffy. Like, it does help, though. Like, how much do I want it now? If some... Huh. Yeah, I don't know. This is iffy. But, so if I sell that, I would have 25, and then I would spend 25 on this, so I'd still have 19 for repairs. That's basically all I would do. So, regardless of whether I do that yet, I am still gonna do the repairs. So how much can I get? I still wanna go up to 20, I think. Maybe a little bit more. I'm likely to get hit by the ASB, so I will get 2 more as well. So I will spend all of this money on repairs. So really just the question is, do I sell this? I think I won't. I'm gonna play it a little bit risky, but a little bit greedy. Try and keep this, and then maybe I'll get a drone system later and be able to make use of this. We'll see, though. I can still sell it later if I need to. Alright, what kind of ship are we generating here? Okay, that looks scary, but honestly it's not as bad as it could be. What this means is I can direct my shield power into my engines, so now I have full engines power. I can get away as fast as I can with this ship. So that's nice. You don't really need 3 shields against a single Vulcan in isolation. Okay, that's a little bit nasty. How's this gonna work? We don't really need to man our weapons anymore. I mean, that's nice and all, but I don't really need that. I guess you can just keep this in the background. You can help reinforce, I guess. We'll vent you out of doors. You're gonna go into engines. Better just do this now. Not try and, like, eke out the last few microseconds and do this wrong. Just do it right now. So you go... Oh, you're going into there. Alright, fine. I'm okay with this. Might as well, Alright, so that turned off the Vulcan. Not what I want, but that's fine. Okay, so the way I could need to do this, actually, is I need to shoot an ion blast at their weapons. That will turn off the Artemis, if it, lands. I will go ahead and shoot another Leo, too, just to keep him busy. So hopefully that will land... Alright, so good. The ion landed and it turned off the Artemis. So that's probably gonna save us one more, Alright, so where is that going? Is it gonna hit our crew? Kinda looks like it might. No, it's gonna hit our piloting. Of course. Piloting, the one system you don't want to be hit in this scenario. Alright, so you get off engines. You need to fix that a jiffy. It looks like... Oh, you're not quite winning. Oh, alright, so you go over here. You help out. No, I said... Alright, you abandon here. You go over here to fix. You sub in as a fresh replacement. Now, you have more health. You have more health. You guys should both win. The oxygen system should help keep this oxygenated for a little while. I'm gonna go ahead and shoot another Leto, because I don't want them to hit our crew with, this. That could be really bad. Alright, you guys are still the best repairmen we have, so you get on engines. I mean, eventually you're gonna need to help. You guys are repairing as fast as you can. We don't really need shields, I guess it helps. Let's fire this. Maybe it gets this offline if we're lucky. No. Alright. You guys are still trying to repair piloting. Okay, piloting's up. Now we can maybe dodge this. I want to shoot another Leto. We're nearly out of here. Alright, so that's gonna hit. Nothing important. It's gonna cause a breach, but that's okay. You're just sitting in the med bay for no reason. Guess you might as well go over here. Not that it really matters. I think we're just about out. Okay. So I think we took 7 damage. That's a lot, but it's not that bad. Could have been a lot worse. That's part of why we bought all those cheap repairs, was to make stuff like this possible. And I'm definitely gonna go Mantis controlled. Zoltans are still kind of nasty with our setup. We don't really have hugely great weapons at breaking through their systems, and we don't have the defense drone up yet. Whereas Mantis controlled, we can really make use of that Leto missile and hit them before they can hit us. So I think that's going to be better for us overall. This is why way back in episode 1, when I picked these two options, I didn't want to go all the way up here because maybe these could have been too Zoltan controlled. But now I have an actual choice, so I can dodge the Zoltan controlled. Yeah, see, paying dividends. All right, we'll fix that. Get everybody all fixed up and, you know, keep going on. I think we're still in good shape. Yeah, you guys get out of there. Let's not risk your lives for no reason. No, not for no reason. We'll risk them for a reason, but not no reason. I mean, I can kind of see, like, maybe you want to keep that there is like a speed hole, but our venting on this ship is alright. Especially for the front section, it's pretty good, so I don't really see any reason to keep that breach around for extra fast venting. It's down here when you might want better venting, because it takes a while for air to empty from, like, out here, to, like, through these rooms. But at the same time, it's kind of a bottleneck, so you might not want this room to always be airless anyway. Anyway, 3 shields might actually keep us pretty safe. We'll have to see. I mean, we're just gonna have to see what opponents we run into. So always scan the exit. That's pretty good. Pretty good connectivity over here. This is a pretty friendly sector overall. I mean, as far as being able to jump wherever we want is concerned. So yeah, I think we just want to get into a whole bunch of fights. Maybe some distresses, but mostly just fights. Okay, I think we can take these guys. And we can certainly take all their money. Sun, sun, and sun. Okay. Well, we might go there, or we might not. I think empty beacons in Mantis sectors are usually a little bit worse than usual, because I think there's, like, more empty beacons in these kinds of sectors specifically or something. There's certainly not a lot of free stuff events in here, so I think we just want to just hit all the ships. So something like this, 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 and then just keep zigzagging and see what our timer looks like after that. Might be able to sneak, like, a few extra beacons down here or something. But yeah, hit all the points of interest. Alright, well, who's up first? Okay. So these guys are the, your ship will make a mighty fine prize guys. These guys can actually give you another weapon. If you hit them enough and then let them run away, you will get a quest marker to follow them and you can get another weapon from that. This is not really hinted at all. I think you were just meant to discover this by accident. But, usually it's not a good idea to let people run away. In this case, I'm just mulling it over. I might want to just blow them up anyway. Yeah, I'll go ahead and vent you. No particular reason to do anything. Obviously, these guys can't hurt us. This is one shot, this is two shot. There's no way they can get through three shields at all, which is great for us. So I'll go ahead and turn... I'll leave that on, just in case. But, yeah, I think I just want to let them run away. Because if they, Even if the bomber it generates later is hard, I don't think it's going to be that bad most of the time. And I'd certainly like another weapon to fit in our fourth slot, so, anytime you don't have to pay for a weapon is great. Let's see if I can hit this guy, though. Not quite. I just wanted to make sure they can't repair all that well. Although, really, for a ship like this, you don't want to, like... More times than I can count, I've, like, set a fire and then, like, accidentally, cause it so that they can't actually, run away because I, like, set their engines on fire or something. Yeah, sure. You go in there. That is gonna turn the artillery beam on, but I think we should be done in here before then. So, yeah, actually I might not want to bully them too much. I mean, this is, I probably, if I do want to let them run away. So, I guess I'll just hit weapons. Yeah, see, they're gonna make a hasty getaway, but they can't actually run away because nobody's piloting the darn ship. So we actually just kind of have to let them fix everything, which is gonna be a little while. But on the plus side, at least we can get some weapons training in while we're, okay. Their jump timer is very fast in this event, so as long as they can actually get to the piloting and fulfill all the conditions, they will jump away quickly, which is risky if you're boarding. So yeah, after them. Alright, where is that quest? It's over here. In fact, it overwrote one of the sun beacons, which I'm very happy about, so that certainly makes things better. So yeah, we'll probably be able to get a free weapon here, which is gonna be nice. I mean, I don't know how useful it'll be. It's gonna be a random one, but we'll see. So, sector priorities are probably just get the engines online fully. Maybe even think about upgrading the artillery beam from spend 50 scrap to turn it from a 40 second into a 30 second. That is quite a bump and improvement, but it's power hungry. So I'll think about it. There's, as we know now from the scan, the store is all the way back there, so we're not going to have a defense drone this whole sector. So that's fine, but might be a little bit iffy on our hull. So is there anything else we can upgrade on our ship that helps us kill the ship better? Maybe doors? Doors so that we can put somebody on shields and repair things a little bit better? Maybe? I don't think there's really anything else that helps other than the artillery beam. And I don't think we want to spend 75 scrap on a buffer right now when there's more important stuff to go after. Well, we'll think about it. But I don't think there's really anything to worry about right now. Right now, we just got to get our fights in. Okay, this could actually be pretty nasty. Their lasers are going to have trouble getting through us, but we'll have to see where the bombs land. I will go ahead and attack the ship, though. Yeah, we're just going to have to see. Probably worth shooting a Leto missile at this one, too, just to turn off one of these four things. Any ship with four weapons is always noteworthy. Okay, that's fine, honestly. Now they can't get through our shields unless they hit us in the shields. Alright, so weakened you a little bit. We'll go ahead and spare another shot at the weapons. Alright, so they have a small bomb and some other bomb that's probably either a fire bomb or a stun bomb. Either of which could be nasty. I mean, usually they're not that bad, but we're gonna have to see. Alright, you're dying, that's good. Starting to look like stun bomb, maybe. We kind of want to dodge the bomb if possible. We'll see. Let's get you to the med bay. It is an ion bomb, which I didn't even remember that these things could have, so that's good to know. Thankfully, it's useless, but could have done something. Glad it didn't. Thankfully, I don't have to worry about my crew health quite as much anymore. Alright, anything else I can do? Not really. I could have turned my shields down to try and dodge that a bit better, but it's fine. Alright, so now all they can hit us with is the bombs, and that's not so bad, if it's just the bombs. Their Mantis is repairing that, so I think I just want to hit engines now. Keep this going. I will go ahead and turn my shields off and try and dodge this a little bit better. Alright, that bomb's there, and that bomb's there. Great. Yeah, that's, that hard mode targeting. I mean, we had nasty hard mode targeting in that first Sector 1 battle at the very start of the game, but, you know, sometimes they don't really know how to use bombs right. Sometimes their targeting computer just can't lock onto our ship. Yeah, I'll go ahead and do this. Alright, they blew up our sensors. Guess we could better go fix those. You know, so that we know what temperature it is in this room in between the medbay and the weapons. I mean, that's important to know. We gotta know the argon concentrations and the ambient magnesium levels. Yeah, man. Alright, let's move on. I guess like I was saying earlier, I think all we really need is more power. Just be able to dodge things a little bit more effectively and keep all this stuff online at the same time. If we get a little bit more, we can even start diverting some stuff back into the artillery beam just for fun. But there's no need to do that yet. We will go ahead and hit this first just because it's awkward to jump back to it later, whereas if we go up here, then down this way. Then we can hit these in a more natural eastward, rightward flow. Alright, standard affair. They can't even hurt us unless our shields get set on fire by the sun, so that's certainly good news. Keep the Leto online just in case, but can't think we're really gonna need it all that often. What do I want to hit? Maybe I don't want to hit piloting, because they'll fix that pretty quick. I guess shields. I really just want to get the, NG to, be busy repairing something, so I can hit either, piloting or, engines. Now, they're gonna get hit by this sun a lot worse than we will. Yeah, I want to hit engines so that we can land more of this stuff. I think I set... Did I set a fire, or... No, he just finished repairing the, shields. But thankfully, he's repairing the engines, so now I can just, hammer the engines as much as I can. They won't be able to repair that real well. And I was hoping that, we'd get the shields completely ionized for this, but no such luck. Still, that's okay. I'll go ahead and use these airlocks to help out. Sometimes it's gonna be a little bit slow. Alright, so now that, like, nigh instantly, became oxygenless, and hopefully that'll just go out in a, reasonable amount of time. There we go. Alright, our jump drive is charged, so we can get our oxygen turned back on. And yeah, they should be toast pretty soon, one way or another. No need to hit that, so... I don't know. Piloting, sure. Why not? Our oxygen was getting a little bit low, so probably a good idea to just let it fill up while we're doing all this. And yeah, they really can't dodge well at all, because at the most, they've only ever had one engine level, so that's not much. And will they blow up before the sun hits us? Yes, they will. So you can take that reward and immediately jump out. There we go. Don't have to risk hull damage from that. So you can see we're not taking much damage. Three shields and five engines is actually really good defense. We don't have a defense drone or hacking or any other kind of auxiliary defense, but this is actually pretty good for this early in the game. That's why I like to rush level 3 shields if I can, because there's a lot of ships like this one, which certainly could have been pretty nasty if we had only 2 shields, but with 3 they can really barely hurt us. Nevertheless, I will hit their, I will go ahead and spare a dual laser shot at their weapons just to make sure that they can't really hurt us that well. Now they should be desynced a little bit better. Yeah, so with that spare to desync them a little bit more, I will go ahead and start, you know, hitting their engines like I was earlier. Because that just kind of compounds on itself. The temporary loss of... I need to actually dodge now. Or do I? Maybe I don't. Yeah, I do. Okay. Oh man, all three of those hit. Maybe I can dodge this. Nope. Okay, all four of those hit. Oh well, that's okay. Yeah, you all go over there. Well, no, it's not that much of an emergency. Never mind. You can do it alone. I turned off the burst too, and there's a mantis repairing it, so no big rush. Hit shield so that the engine gets to go all the way across the ship. Now I can hit engines. You can see I'd like a fourth weapon, like even just the burst laser two, first laser one or something. Or hole laser one or something lousy. Like, just have something else that can do actual hull damage that isn't the dual lasers and the Leto. As you can see, I've got the shields down alright. Like, I wouldn't mind an Ion Blast 1, actually. Just double Ion, get the shields down, then start ionizing other things once the shields are down. That would be fine. Would not mind that on this ship at all. That would be a fine way to develop this weapon system, but almost anything with the fourth slot would work. Anything except a repair bomb. Or a healing blast. Don't want that. Yeah, so, gonna go ahead and get more power. Now, do I want doors? Maybe? I'm doing a lot of running around with my crew, and we are gonna get boarded again, so it's probably smart. Especially because we're gonna fight a bomber soon, which is definitely 100% of the time gonna board us. So, yeah, probably better that I do this. Just as a little bit of insurance. So let's go ahead and jump here, and then here, and then... Well, we'll jump here, and then we'll see. We'll do some counting. See, because I want to hit this. And then the distress, and maybe the store. Like, how many... Let's just do it now, actually. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Do I have 8 jumps before the exit? 4, 5, 7 or so? I might have 7. So I might want to skip this one. So I still want to go to this one, and then that one, and then that one. Although maybe I want to skip this one? I don't know, it's iffy. How soon do I want to do any of this? I get more of a choice if I go here and then here, because then I still have the choice of hitting this later, so I might be able to measure more precisely after the quest. And who knows, maybe after the quest I'll have a good weapon and I won't even want to go to the store. So, maybe that'll be right. But I want to go to the store and probably buy a drone system to use the, defense drone with anyway. Alright, Burst Laser 3. Well, that certainly has the potential to hurt us, but, we might be able to just shut it off before it can even fire, so that's another thing. I'll go ahead and shoot a Leto. We've got 10. We can spare one. That was worth a try. Alright, do you want to shoot another one? Sure, why not? We might not need it soon, so we'll go ahead and do it now. Gives us another chance to maybe shut this off before it finishes firing, like so. So now I don't even have to risk that hurting us for one or two more hull points, which could matter right now. We're not getting those free repairs, like I said, and we are kind of taking some incidental damage that I would kind of prefer we didn't. But yeah, these guys should be toast just like all the other ones. They're not doing that good of a job. I mean, that's the danger of a Burst Laser 3. It's very power-hungry, very slow, usually pretty easy to take offline if you've got fast, directed damage like I do now. Well, this Ion Blast 2 is eventually it's not going to be so good. Right now, it's fine, but once we get to the 3-shielded ship, it's not going to be quite so great as it is now. Honestly, you should just, go beat him up. In fact, yeah, you two just kill him now. Or you can go in there. Sure, why not? I think I killed their NG by accident, but I don't really care. Alright, more money. Yes, excellent, more money. You can see we're already getting a little bit low down on fuel, even though, we had, like, 30 at one point. We're down to 15, and it would not take much to make us down to, like, 7. But at the same time, fighting all these fights will certainly get us more fuel, so that's good. Yeah, I think we're going right to the quest. Do I want to spend money first? Maybe. Maybe. It would help. Like, buying one more power means we can have 5 engines and also power up the artillery beam to maybe do something 50 seconds in, although if we're still, like, up in the air as to whether we're winning or not after 50 seconds are gone, that's probably not good. Like, the Leto is gonna do more for us than the power would, I think. So I think we're just gonna save our money. Might wind up going to that store. Because it sounds like at this point we're going to need to repair the store anyway. Okay, an even bigger ship. That's fine. I'm okay with seeing these weapons. Now, they do have 3 shields, but we can still handle that. Because they have a few more crew, but not that many, and also they're missing their medbay, which is unusual. This one, like, this nearly always has a medbay, but not this time. Not this time. So, this is a fairly weak setup. It's kind of unlikely to hurt us, so as long as we can keep that missile suppressed, we're in pretty good shape. I just hope it's a Leto instead of an Artemis. Now, they do have 2 Mantis orders, which is a little annoying, but thankfully we upgraded our doors. Even if I hadn't, this wouldn't be such a big deal, because I've got the person manning them. I'll go ahead and close that door to trap that guy. And yeah, I'll turn to close these two. So, yeah, so that's all handled. Even if I had level 1 doors and I was manning them, this would be okay. And anything else? No. Fire that lead over there, and hopefully we can get a strong start here. Alright, not what I wanted to take offline. It's gonna be a while before that goes off. That is an Artemis, like I thought. That's okay, though. So, in this case... Okay, miss. Nice. I think I'm just going to go ahead and keep shooting more Letos at this. We need to get that offline yesterday. Alright, so they're both weak. Ideally, they shouldn't be able to repair much. Just keep in mind that this engine's guy and this shield's guy are weak, so we might be able to hit them with shots and kill them. Oh, nice. We actually dodged two Artemis missiles. Just think about this. If we hadn't dodged either of them, we would be down 4 hull points. We'd be down to 9. And that would be a little bit iffy. But we're not out of the woods yet. We haven't actually turned this thing off yet. I think I will go ahead and spare an ion blast at this, because we've been hitting these pretty well. Just barely. Alright, so that lands, that would have, like, if I turned off the mini-beam with that last Leto missile, the Ion Blast would have then turned off the Artemis, so that's good. I mean, that's, you know, it was a little bit nicer than it could have been, but even if it hadn't been nice, I would have gotten that turned off. So now that buys us a little bit of reprieve, so now we can start shooting at other stuff. Alright. Ah, that's a little rough. Oh! Nice. They're 2 healthy people are actually going to board us. So now they're weak people are going to be the people who are we're trying to repair stuff. So maybe I can just hit them with that. So I think you're just going to hide up here, at least for the time being. I'm going to reoxygenate these compartments. I'm going to shoot another Leto missile. Because hopefully we're not going to need these soon. Alright, good. In fact, that might even be on fire, actually. Yeah, that might actually just be on fire. Yeah, that might actually be really good. So actually what I want now is you guys... you guys fight in the... Okay, yeah, they're trying to get away again. That's the other thing. Alright, so now... Oh, but I destroyed their engines, and they might be on fire as well, because I don't see the pilot trying to repair them. So I want to... The reason I'm doing this, which is a little bit risky, but they're not going to hurt us soon, is I want to kill these guys as fast as possible. Like, either kill them or get their health real low. Because, if I can... Okay, so yeah, fire's in there. Fire is eventually going to go into the oxygen. If I can get them real low, then none of them are going to be able to put out fires. Alright, you need to get out. Okay, that was a little bit close. A little bit closer than I wanted, but he's very low. none of them are going to be able to fight any fires anymore, which is what I was going for. Which means we're going to be able to get the crew kill on these guys. Alright, so yeah, you don't need to dodge anymore. So yeah, let's take a look, see what we got. Alright, as I suspected, just as I thought, both of these are on fire. Eventually this is going to spread into oxygen and do our job for us. In fact, we might just be able to shoot both of these. Yeah, we might just be able to shoot both. Yeah, that will do nicely. Okay, so do we want a hull beam? Probably not. It doesn't really help us carve through shields. I think it's on average, like, I think you get scrap resources and a weapon if you finish them off, so I will go ahead and finish them off. I mean, that's not bad, but I believe if you finish them off, you basically get to re-roll this, which is really nice. So hurry up, get us out of there. He dies, we get another ion blast, great. And like I thought, you get the scrap and the money, and the fuel and the drone, which is what I was talking about. Now I think this was slightly less money, but we got to re-roll the weapon and we also got fuel out of it, so I think overall it was a good idea to do that. That wasn't a bad roll though. Like, I could have just taken that, that would have been fine, but I wanted to push my luck a little bit. And game rewarded me, at least for pushing my luck this time. So that is real nice. Now we can get shields down, no problem. Although, we will still want to focus on getting a better follow-up for, after the shields are down. But that's not so bad. And, you know, now I want the whole beam. But, you know, can't have everything. So, we've got a good amount of money. We've got the Leto missile, which is good. We've got the defense drone, that's good. We still want to go to the store, though, for two reasons. We want to repair. Maybe we want to buy an auxiliary system now. Our offense is pretty well set, so we really don't need to worry about that much anymore. Eventually, we'll, like, spend 75 to get the Leto online, which is a fine option. But there's better things we could be spending that kind of money on, like a defense drone system, or hacking, or mind control. Any of that would be real good and give us a good leg up. Honestly, I'm pretty surprised we haven't been running into much hacking or mind control much, although that's kind of been just a function of the systems we've gone through. One reason I like going to Mantis-controlled sectors is just because they don't have a lot of extra systems to harass you with. They just have the teleporter and sometimes clone bays, and that's basically it. Yeah, none of that cloaking or mind control nonsense. So let's see, how many jumps we've got left? 1, 2, 3, 4-ish... About 4. So I think I want to go here, distress, then store, and then out. I think that's it. Yeah, it's a shame I couldn't hit more of these with some kind of fleet delay option or something, but, you know, can't mine out the entire sector. So I'll jump here, I'll remeasure, see if I have time to go here or not. I probably don't. So I'm going to go here, then probably distress, store, exit. That's what I'm thinking. I'm not going to spend my money yet. We're a little low on hull, but we've got... Now we have really good offense, so I'm not that concerned about it. And if that's their only hull damaging option, I'm really not concerned at all. Even if they charge that all the way up to 4, which will take them 20 seconds, they don't have that good of a chance of hitting us through all that, and the bomb is probably not going to be a problem. I'll go ahead and go in shields, though, because they're not boarding us. Okay, small bomb, where's that going? It is going to the med bay. Don't get blown up by that. We'll go ahead and turn that off, make sure they can't get through, and just keep hammering their evasion. Because once we can get this ion to stick, then they're going to be hopeless, because now we have two extra... With two ion weapons, we can get a lot of work done. Okay, there's a fire in there. My oxygen is already off. You might as well try and put that out. It's not like you really need to focus that much on it, but it would be nice. You might as well just stay on piloting, though. Okay, yeah, he's going in there. Okay. Just gonna keep going, hitting evasion. I don't really care about the weapons that much, as I've just said. Just wanna make sure that more of this ion sticks. Alright, there we go. Okay, and now they're trying to power their FTL, which I hadn't really thought about. Alright. So how are we gonna handle this? They're both repairing the engines. They're not gonna leave engines. Because they don't have a medbay, even if I hurt them real bad, they're not gonna run away to go to the medbay because there is no medbay. And it's because my only, like, I think my best option is actually just gonna be to ionize their, weapon, their engine system. So I think I'm gonna divert the Ion Blast 2 over here and their Ion Blast 1 over there. So that way, when they repair the, engines, they won't actually be able to power them again because it'll be ionized. Now, they might make it through our, alright, how close are you to that? Is it worth it? It's probably... don't want to run right now or run later. I don't think it's going to make a difference for this salvo, so I'm going to at least let you fix the doors. Just to one. Alright, see? They've repaired it, but because it's ionized, they can't, they don't actually have any power in there. So, what's next? Maybe hit piloting just to make sure. Alright, they have level 3 piloting. Alright. Well, that's good to know. And they are charging that up to the full set of 4, so that's a little bit concerning. And we're not gonna be able to dodge any of it. Okay. Well, that's good to know. Alright, yeah, you dodge the bomb, and now you guys fix the piloting for the next cycle. Alright. That, definitely lined up in a way I wasn't expecting at all. No, that is a terrible surrender. No. Alright, our oxygen is off. It's getting a little low. We should probably fix that too, maybe. You know what, they're nearly dead, so I will go ahead and take our, weapons guy off of weapons. I think we can get this next shot in fast enough for that. You just need to keep working on that. Dodge that. Alright, they're dead, so now you can help repair the oxygen. We'll restabilize. And we'll fix that oxygen before it's an actual issue. Yeah. We're out of oxygen, it's fine, don't worry about it. Alright, we've got our weakest members in the medbay. Got a little bit of hypoxia going on, it's fine, look. See, everything's okay. Nothing to worry about. Yeah, I totally didn't just leave my oxygen off for too long. Not, what are you talking about? Everything's okay. Alright, everybody back to work. I don't pay you to just stand around and chit-chat. Alright, how many jumps left? Still looking like 3. Yeah, so I think all I have time for is distress store exit. We're a little bit low on hull, but we'll fix that when we get to the store. Yeah, sure. Heavy ion. Well, we're not gonna use that, but we will sell it off. And yeah, store and out. Okay, let's do some shopping. What have we got? Give me a lot of stuff to buy. Okay, this is looking more exciting now. There is the fire beam. I don't think I'm going to use the fire beam, but there is a fire beam. Now let's see. I think we're going to get rid of the heavy ion. It doesn't really fit. It is technically a little bit better than the ion blast in this situation because it's better at carving large amounts of enemy shields down. Like if they have 8 bars is 4 shields, and they want to ionize those. This helps us make this go faster. But it's not enough faster that it's worth the extra power. Ion Blast 2 and Ion Blast 1 are going to do the job well enough on their own. So these are basically the 4 weapons I want to go with. I'm not going to buy the Fire Beam. It's hilarious, but it doesn't actually help us do damage faster. And we're not really that well protected. We could buy the Drone Control. So I think at this point, do we want to just buy both of these? We could. Nothing we want on this page. That's fine, they're both good, but how many repairs did we get? Not much. That might not be wise. Hacking is maybe a little bit better for us in this situation than drone control. Because hacking is great with ion because it helps you actually land your stuff better. Or you can hack weapons to delay their weapons while your ions land. It's generally really good and efficient on drone parts. So I think at the very least I'm buying hacking. I don't think that's in question. The question is just, do I sell Defense Drone 1 and buy Drone Control to get the drone system online at the cost of having very low hull? I'm not going to be able to repair much. Let's see, so that'll be... Let's just do the math. So that'll be 97, and then subtract 85. And, yeah, because I'll sell this and then buy it. So 9... Yeah, was it? Yeah 9... 97, yeah. 97 minus 85. So I'd be able to repair 4 hull points and be up to 14 hull. And even though I'd have a drone system and I'd have 3 shields and 5 engines, which is really good for Sector 4, I usually try and get 3 shields and 5 engines by Sector 5. So I am technically about approximately a half a sector to 1 sector ahead of where I'd usually like to be for this. These things, the benchmark. But on the other hand, I could just sell the Defense 1 and then buy, no, not even buy this. I would repair a little bit first at the store, and then eventually raise the money and then buy the Leto missile. Because then I'd have both of these, the dual lasers and the Leto missile and the hacking, and that really helps me shut down the enemy weapons a lot better than just these alone. And then, you know, eventually I could turn on the artillery beam, too, eventually. The funny thing about this that I don't actually see all that often is you can, like, hack enemy weapons with, like, level 3 hacking or something, and then turn on the artillery beam, and that buys you more time to charge the artillery beam up, too. So that's another synergy. So, yeah, I'm not sure if drone control really does enough for me. Like, 14 hull is... okay, but it's a little bit risky. There's certainly other enemy setups that could do more damage to us really fast and put us in uncomfortable hull territory. I think I would rather just be a good hull and trust my regular sets of this stuff to get me through, and then eventually get the Leto online. Because again, sometimes the best defense is a good offense, and having that extra Leto online to keep hitting enemy weapon systems and also, like, mess with them with the hacking, that's going to do a lot to help keep enemy weapons down, and especially missiles, and hopefully keep us in a little bit healthier shape. And it's just good to be at, like, nice high hull. Like, I'm almost thinking about repairing up to 25 now, which would not be wrong. Like, that's pretty good. We're going to be taking little bits of scratch damage from tiny missiles now, even with the hacking, so it's probably wise. I think I'll go ahead and do that. It does put off the day when we can actually get the Leto on, but I think it's wise. Alright, yeah, so I guess we could have done this in a different order, dived the exit, gone to the store last, and then jumped here. This is less risky, though. It probably would have been okay, but I don't know. That's just something to take note of. I could have jumped here, then the exit, then the store, then out. Which would have been more fuel, but I had fuel and would have been more... I don't know. Something to think about. Could have done that, just didn't end up doing it. So I can spare the drones. Do I want to... I'm not really using the missiles that much right this second, so... Alright. That'll help. It'll help me keep power the hacking, of course. Alright, I think we're in pretty good shape, though. I think there were a lot of different ways that I could have been in good shape, but this is one way in which I can be in good shape.